From the Chum Television Building in downtown Toronto, Bravo presents Live at the Rehearsal Hall, featuring Kathleen Edwards.
Ladies and gentlemen, Kathleen Edwards.
Good evening, everybody. My name is Lance Chilton. Welcome to the Rehearsal Hall tonight. Our special guest tonight is Kathleen Edwards. You know, it's not every artist who can write a catchy melodic song about an armed standoff that ends very badly. The standoff, not the song. But Kathleen Edwards has that gift, and one of the things that those of us who know her music really like about her is that she really, really knows how to write songs about life. And she does it so well that on the strength of her first album, Failure, Rolling Stone magazine tipped her as one of its top 10 artists to watch. You're going to find out why. Here's Kathleen Edwards. Rehearsal Hall tonight, our guest is Kathleen Edwards. Great to have you here. It's our first time meeting. It's a pleasure because I got to know your music before meeting you. And I have to say, one of the things that I was surprised about reading about you after having heard your music was that you grew up as a diplomat's kid in that international community in Geneva and Seoul, and that you studied classical violin, which is, it's not what I expected having heard your sound. So draw the line from
classical... My parents are extremely disappointed in me.
I'm sure they're not. Draw the line from classical violin to your first album, Failure.
Well, I studied classical violin for about 12 years off and on.
Yeah, it's a long time.
My parents would say probably with less effort at the end of the 12 years. And I think it started because my brother got a guitar. Mm. I think he like saved up $400 and he went down to Steve's music store in Ottawa and bought a Yamaha. And I always ended up stealing it, and I get in trouble for that. And I made the transition at summer camp. And it was like this big culture in Tomogamy, Ontario, like mm-hmm. to be a hippie kid and play Neil Young songs. And that's where I actually learned how to play like the D chord and the G chord. And then it just sort of went
sort of the
there.
Uncomplicated approach to music after 12 years of classical training.
Yeah, and I really connected with the idea of just teaching myself. Like, I really loved playing violin. It had sort of given me a chance to learn how to do things just by listening. And then I was able to apply it without having a teacher making me cry. I do have tear stains on my violin. No, my teacher was great. He was wonderful. But I look at my violin sometimes and there's still these tear stains on my violin.
In the varnish, yeah.
Yeah, they're permanent.
Do you call it a fiddle now or still a violin?
I'd still call it a violin.
Okay, I'm just curious.
I'm definitely not a fiddler. Like, you know, I'm certainly no Ann Lindsay or Natalie right. McMaster.
Gotcha.
I basically great can do Twinkle, Twinkle, Little Star in any variation of that song, and I'm
there you go.
I'm good.
12 years of classical violin from that. So some songwriters, yeah, well, again, about your parents being disappointed. Some songwriters make statements, some tell stories. I'm going to take the liberty of putting you in that latter category and ask you what kind of stories you like to tell.
I like listening to songs and feeling like there's this cinematic feeling to the song, and it may not be what the writer intended, but you always get something
out
of it that you can think of and imagine or see or feel. Or I like listening to somebody and almost being able to see them enact the song that they're writing.
Yeah. So how do you do that? How do you write little stories? What's that? I mean, when I say little, I mean there's 3 minutes. There's a beginning, middle, and end. Yeah. The little campfire stories.
Yeah.
But how do you start? Do you start with a riff? Do you start with watching the news or what have you?
A lot of stories I just get little pieces of from something that happened to me, maybe directly or indirectly. Like I wrote the song 6 o'clock News, and it's obviously not about my life because it's about a guy, and he's obviously got a violent past, and
it's an armed standoff song.
Yeah,
from that genre.
Well, you know, and in my past I've no, it has nothing to do with me. But I thought it was sort of relevant because at the time that I wrote it, there were all these incidents of husbands locking themselves, which still happens today, which is the really...
Oh, domestic said that
it's basically a story about domestic violence. And unfortunately, I think the song kind of glorifies it, but I don't mean that. I don't mean to do that. But I just think it's kind of an interesting thing to see the people that you love the most and you're the closest to are the ones that endure the most dark side of you, and I think that's always kind of interesting. That's
the price that those we live with pay, isn't
it? My band knows exactly what I'm talking about. No, I like writing about stuff that's dark, but also because I think there is a romanticism to stuff that's sort of dark, but I think there's also hope in that too.
All right, let's have some more music, Kathleen.
All right.
All right. Kathleen Edwards.
Thanks.
Thank you. speeding all the way, alone in the rain. I was rehearsing afar, from down at the bar. My mouth smelled like a drink, and we were laughing at things.
Kathleen Edwards live at the Rehearsal Hall tonight. And that was a song called Away from your new album, Back to Me. Oh, they're back. Well, you got a great band.
Let's meet.
We have an ace up our sleeve, too, but just a second. First, can we meet your band?
On guitar, and the producer of my record. This is Colin Cripps. And on the drums, the funniest man in show business. Joel Anderson. And on the keyboards, before I introduce him, I have to tell you that I covered one of his songs on my new record. It's called Somewhere Else, and he's probably one of my biggest influences. This is Jim Bryson. And on the bass, this is Kevin McCarriger.
You're going to do a song called Hockey Skates from Failure, and why don't you draw the surprise ace card now? One, two, three, go.
All right, here we go. Everybody, are you ready? Mr. Jim Cuddy.
Sounds beautiful.
I'm so tired of consequences and the look on your face. Well, I'm so tired of playing defense, and I don't even have hockey skates.
You could see it in his eyes.
And I didn't get a chance to say this before when you introduced your band, but they're fantastic.
Sorry.
You guys are truly great. Rock solid.
They are.
They are rock solid.
I don't really pay them enough.
No, well, no one pays musicians enough, period, anyway, so don't feel too badly about that. Yeah. You're
they
a musician, aren't you?
I'm very lucky.
Yeah.
Very lucky girl.
You
I
are.
Stole Jim Cuddy's band, really, was what happened.
Now, I have to say that one of the things that I really like about your music is that it sounds like it could have been written any time in the last 30 or 40 years. You know what I'm saying? It doesn't sound like you know, you listen to Flock of Seagulls, you know you're stuck in the 80s. You listen to, oh, I don't know, you listen to Early Kiss, you know you're stuck in the 70s. But your music, you don't hear a when there. It's not, you know, I don't hear like a trend, oh, Kathleen's doing a this or a that or, you know.
Well, that's really nice. Thank you.
You're welcome. We can leave it at that.
I think the music situation right now, popular music, is pretty, it's pretty tough to make it.
Mm-hmm.
Like, even to be on this show, a lot of people have to be behind you, and...
We have very careful screening procedures.
That's right. Yeah. I had to go through a full, medical physical to get on this show. And, you know, I just
Not
think,
true.
You know, it's really nice that you say that. I like to think that. I'd like to think that, you know, here's a band. We don't play to backtracks.
Mm-hmm.
We don't, you know, we're a live band.
Yeah.
And we went and made a record that I think honors the fact that we can deliver those songs live. And you know what? It's tough. It is really tough to make it, to even tour as a Canadian recording artist. And I'd like to do something that's genuine and not something that's just going to be... And I think people... I hope that people recognize, like, the girls from the women.
Yeah.
I don't mean that. I'm sorry.
No, well, no, and this is where I usually step in and slag Britney Spears, but I'm not going
to.
No,
I don't mean her at all.
Yeah.
I think she works with great producers, and they do an amazing job. I just think, like...
No Colin Cripps, mind you, but still.
I know, there's no Colin Cripps, but...
Well, let me ask you this. When you say you make it as a musician, what define that? I mean, you had a whale of critical acclaim, and you sold a decent number of records for your first album, Failure. And so define, like, when you say made it, I mean, what
I
is
mean,
that?
Like,
you know, is it like the 10-year overnight sensation? Or?
It is. I still struggle to pay my rent. And I love what I do, and I wouldn't change it for anything, but... It is tough. We spent so many days out on the road last year. These guys all have families at home, and it's not easy.
It's not for the faint of heart.
And we haven't made it. Like, it's not like, but I feel like very lucky that I get to come and play on this show, and I get to go, and I've played on David Letterman, and I've played at the SARS Fest, and that's really special stuff.
Yeah.
And it makes all of the paying you do stuff worthwhile.
No matter when you do it. Before,
totally.
Yeah, absolutely.
I'm actually haven't paid my dues yet. I got to do all the good stuff first, and now I'm going to be starving for the rest of the
huge critical acclaim, years. And then pay your dues. But whichever way it comes, that's fine.
That's right.
How do you write songs? Are you disciplined about it, or do you have to go and hide in a hole or a cabin in Quebec, or do you write on the road?
Everyone's different. I can't write on the road.
No.
But I like writing in a very quiet space, and I don't sit down and try to write a song every day, because I'm really not that good.
Yeah. Yeah, you are. We think so, because like I said, we have a very careful screening process.
That's right, medical.
We're glad you passed it, Kathleen. It's great to see you here. Congratulations on your new album. It's called Back to Me.
Thanks
for being here. Thanks, band, for being here. You guys are great. Sure. Thanks, Kathleen.
Thanks for having me.
Thank you. It's our pleasure.
for coming this year, really. Thank you. We didn't mess up once for live television.